what is the definition of gender equity? And why, what I would tell you is that that's a definition that has changed through the years and through the waves of the women's movement. The first wave was suffrage. 1848, Seneca Falls, through 1920, the enactment of the 19th Amendment. And gender equity in that period would have been defined in terms of citizenship, equal opportunity to participate in the governance of this country through the vote, through the ability to run for office. Then comes the second wave. It comes out of the civil rights movement. It comes out of the anti-war movement. It comes out of sort of a generational shift, as the generation that spawned and raised the baby boomers is, those young people are finally about to enter the workforce, entering their college years and the workforce, and those women are looking around and saying, we got to help pay for the college for these kids, but also, what else? This was a well-educated generation that had tasted some professional freedom just a little bit during World War II, many of them, and they were eager for more. And so in that second wave, that's the wave we're going to talk about mostly today with this book I wrote. The second wave, generational equity was mostly defined in occupational terms, breaking glass ceilings, opening professional doors that had been closed to women. When my mother's generation, Rosalie's generation, came of age, there weren't very many professional opportunities for women. You could be a secretary, you could be a nurse, you could be a teacher. A couple of other fields were open to you, but that was kind of about it. And that changed explosively during the period that begins about 1968, 69, and into the next 20 years or so.